students and welcome to Physical Education and Health. Today we are going to talk about Lapay Bantigi, a well-known folk dance here in the Philippines. So at the end of the lesson, you should be able to know the meaning of folk dance, identify the classification of folk dance, and discuss the background and context of the dance Lapay Bantigi, and also perform the dance competencies of Lapay Bantigi properly. So let's look back our lesson about the FITD principle. So it is a great way of monitoring your exercise program. Also, it is the key components or training guidelines for an effective exercise program. The FITD principle stands for frequency, intensity, time, and type, wherein the frequency refers to the frequency or exercise undertaken or how often you exercise. Next is the intensity. In intensity, it refers to the intensity of exercises undertaken or how hard you exercise. And the time, it refers to the time you spend exercising or how long you exercise for. Next is the type. Type is refers to the type of exercise undertaken or what kind of exercise you do. Ready. As a brief introduction of folk dance, so with each passing year, custom and beliefs of group of people built little by little, slowly with time forming into traditions. Well, folk dance represents one of the strongest way of these countries and regions that can be showcased to the public. Even though many traditional dances bear the name as of an ethnic dance, not all of them remain folk dance, but all of them try to emphasize the cultural roots of the particular dance. So, some of them more feed over the time into religious dances, and as such, they are not primarily used to showcase the tradition, but to enhance the religious ceremonies and beliefs. Such dances are often called religious or ritual dances. So, dance or dancing is said to be a stress reliever. It is a form of exercise that will help boost the immune system through cardio exercise in a form of Zumba, hip-hop, aero, and dance aerobics. So many of this time comes in different forms and in nature. And one of these is the ethnic or folk dance. So in this lesson, you will learn one dance offered in the curriculum, which is the folk dance. So what is an ethnic dance or folk dance? So a folk dance is a dance developed by people that reflect the life of the people of a certain country or region. So not all ethnic dances are folk dance. For example, ritual dances or dances of ritual origin are not considered to be folk dance. Ritual dances are usually called religious dances because of their purpose. So the term ethnic and traditional are used when it is required to emphasize the cultural or the cultural roots of the dance. In this sense, nearly all folk dance are called ethnic dance. So, what about the Philippine folk dance? So, there are so many kind of folk dance here in the Philippines. But the history of Philippine folk dance incorporate influences from immigrants and conquerors, while at the same time maintaining distinctly Filipino roots. So, for Philippine folk dancing is a true reflection of daily life in past centuries while enchanting modern audience at the same time. So, we have the classification of folk dance. or the classification of Philippine folk dance. So we have the nature of folk dance. So that means it can be occupational dance, religious ceremonials, comic dance, game dance, wedding dance, courtship dance, festival dance, and war dance. So there are so many nature of Philippine folk dance here in the Philippines. So when we say occupational folk, occupational dance, it depicts action of a particular occupation. While in religious or ceremonial, it is associated with religion, vows and ceremonies. So when we say comic dance, it depicts funny movements for entertainment. And game dances is done with play elements. While wedding dance performed during wedding feasts, and courtship dances depicts the art of courtship. While festival dance, it is suitable for special occasions. And war dances is it is a dance that show imagery combat. And now let us focus on this folk dance named Lapay Bantige. So meaning seagulls of Bantige Island in Masbate. So it has a dance culture of coastal Christians. So the origin of this dance is in Bantige Island, Masbate. And the classification of this dance, it can be comic or mimetic dance. So like many small islands, Bantige of Masbate rely on the sea to supply fish to great parts of the Bicol region. So each dawn, Bantige village awaits the arrival of boats with their catch. So gathered on the beach with the people are thousands of lapay or seagulls flying overhead or moving around the sand and seashores. So to while away their time, people turn their attention to the lapay, showing them or imitating their flight, swoop, dives, and glides. So this playful frolicking or frolicking started the first step of the unrehearsed dance. So music was brought in later to lend order and form. So it did not take long before couples competed in show of lapay antiques, the very core of what lapay is today. All right, so for the costume of Lapay Bantige, for female, we have the baro and saya, and also the tapis. So for male, we have the camisa de chino and colored pisan pants rolled up just below the knee. After learning about the folk dance, the Philippine folk dance, and also the background and context of Lapay Bantige, you are now ready to perform this dance. So for the dance competencies of Lapay Bantige, you may now click the link in the description box.